Got this shirt from the Animal Expo, and it's like, it feels like I'm wearing a burlap sack. It's re really bad quality, but there's a beautiful sloth on it, so it's all worth it, right? My dogs have been barking like crazy today. They've been literally so annoying. I'm about to remove them from my will. So you're probably gonna hear them barking in the background. What are we doing today? I saw Laura Lee and Manny upload a video where they redid their very first, like, what was it? Like Instagram photo or YouTube tutorial. And I just thought Nikki Tutorials. Nikki Tutorials is like one of the most famous, you know, makeup YouTubers out there. She's one of the most talented out there. So I thought it would be really fun to dig way, 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 way back. This is me digging. If you weren't sure, this is like a dog on its side, like running in its sleep. What is this? I don't know. I'm gonna stop that. I'm scaring people. I'm scaring your children that are watching this with you. I'm sorry. I thought it'd be really fun to dig way, way, way back in her videos 9 years ago and go to her very first makeup tutorial and recreate it all for you. What follow it, react to it, etc. So I'm gonna put some chapstick on. My lips are dry. I drank too much wine last night. So I didn't end up actually grabbing Nikki's very first tutorial, and the reason why is because the quality was so bad. And I'm not hating. My first YouTube video, I think I actually removed it because I filmed it with a laptop and it looked terrible. It looked even worse than hers. So I think we can all admit that our very first YouTube videos are not our best work. I mean, it never is. So nobody's first try of anything, I don't think, is very good. So the quality was really bad. I couldn't really see what she was using, and I couldn't really like hear what she was using either. So I didn't think it would be like a very interesting video because I couldn't really tell the shades she was using. So I used like the third to first video, if that makes sense. Like her first video, her second one, and I think I'm doing her third one. No matter what, this will be very interesting. We all change over time, and I think it's gonna be really cool to like recreate one of her looks, not some of her looks, just one. Now, Nikki Tutorials, I tried to find a video that she had no foundation on, and she did her foundation on in the video, but she didn't really do that in the beginning of her YouTube career. She had makeup and eyebrows on every single video, and then I started going back further. I was like, I'll just pull one from another video, but then it wasn't staying true to this video title where it was like the first video. So I figured that I would just come on camera like Nikki did a long time ago. So here we go. I am Nikki Tutorials. Let's do this. Oh, the intro. So pretty.
Hey everyone, today we're going to do this look. I really love it, and yeah, I don't want to do a too long intro, so I think.
That is like the world's shortest intro. Like, hats off. Like, I don't think I could do an intro that short if I tried.
That's it. Right? Okay. I hope you like
Okay.
it. Bye.
I hope you like it by turns up, turn reaches forward, turns off the camera. I love it. I love it. She even had her like little like beginning intro situation going on.
Okay.
I did not have one of those. Like, I had one like a really long time ago, but I love that. It's like all colorful and everything.
Okay. To start off, you're going to apply a base to prevent your eye from creasing. Okay, so I already did that. I used Henley Paint Pot by MAC. And now we're going to apply our crease first.
We're gonna apply our crease first. Where's my crease brush? Okay, here it is.
And we're going to use Old Gold Pigment by MAC.
I don't use MAC, so we're gonna be using Shayla's Perception eyeshadow palette. I'm gonna be using a D-Sky. This is a TF.
And put your brush like.
She's using a flat brush for the crease. Oh my gosh, I used to too. Nikki, you and I, same thing. I guess that's what I'm gonna use, guys. We gotta follow this. So she looked like she had like a brush like this, so I'm just gonna use this. You guys know that when I get scared to put eyeshadow on after I've put foundation on, so I always flip-flop it. So I'm a little nervous right now. It looks like she's already grabbed it on her brush. I'm just gonna get in here. Got it on her brush.
This. and then go in for it. Like this. Go inwards. And then when you come here, go like this.
Go like this.
So start like this. And when you come into the chair, that put your brush like that.
Okay, so when you're using a flat brush, you gotta do it wide like this. And then when you get in here, you flip it like that. Now that is some shit I didn't even know when I was starting makeup. Okay, I don't hate it.
Okay, when you've applied that, you grab some nylon.
Oh, she already has it on both eyes. I gotta catch up. Okay though, hang on Shayla. This shade is so pretty. Real quick, not to take anything away from making tutorials, wonderful tutorial that we're watching, but the 100 is about to end and summer's about to hit and I'm scared because I'm not gonna have anything to watch. Like what am I gonna do with my life? I'm actually gonna have to go outside and stuff. It's so hard to make it even with this brush. I'm lucky the shade's like really beautiful because I'm gonna need all the help I can get.
Nylon by MAC. Sorry. This color, I love that color. One of my favorites. And with that 239, go in that nylon and pack it on the lid with patting motions.
We're gonna pack it on the lid with patting motions. She used a smaller flat brush, so I'm gonna use a smaller flat brush. Now, we don't have that shade in this palette, so I'm gonna go ahead and use Undressed right here from Laura Lee's palette. We're gonna use patting motions and put this on the eyelid. Are we not gonna blend what's in our crease right now? Like, what's happening? What is gonna happen?
Because when you pat your eyeshadow on, the pigmentation stays the strongest, if you know what I mean. So if you swipe it, the pigmentation goes like it fades out. But if you pat it, you get the most pigmentation of the shadow. So get that on the lid.
We need more, I guess.
Until you have something like this.
Okay, I'm gonna add more of this lighter shade.
Then, grab some old gold pigment again with that 239 and reapply it.
Ogle pigment? Oh, the gold pigment. Okay, I thought that was a brand. I was like, cause she was talking about another. My beauty blender just fell in the trash. Hold please.
Come back to me, my love.
She was talking about a brand that, oh, hi. Hi, in focus, thank you. She was talking about a brand that you couldn't get when you couldn't get MAC and another lens, I guess, and it was called like Gosh or something like that. I forget, but she said it was the only loose pigment that you could get in another lens, which I thought was crazy. Okay, so we're doing this again.
Like that. Just so it's nice and vibrant again. And then grab your 217 and the spiced chocolate quad and grab some spiced chocolate.
I don't have spiced chocolate or 217. Let's see what this brush looks like.
The brown color. And
we're gonna use Butt Naked right here from Laura Lee's palette. Actually, oh no, that's too dark. Yeah, we're gonna use the Butt Naked shade from Laura Lee's palette.
Apply this to the outer crease and...
This is a fluffier brush.
Your outer V. So like this, swirl at that eye socket, go in, and then go a little bit in your crease. Don't go all the way in because we want that outer part to be dark. So swipe it inwards, go a little bit in your crease.
Just a little bit. She inserted a picture of the finished look, but the video is only halfway through. What's happening? Okay, let me catch up. Let's catch up here. Okay, I didn't even know about swirling your eyeshadow brush 9 years ago, so I'm freaking impressed. Like, I don't even know. I didn't know anything about makeup 9 years ago. Oh my gosh. We're not gonna blend that out? You know what? I feel like she might have blended it a little bit more with that flatter brush than I did, and I'm gonna do that because it looks way more blended than mine right now. And we just can't have this right here. But I was like, girl, you better blend it. You better blend your little heart out with that flat brush in the crease. I think I would like cringe so hard if I actually had to like do a legit makeup look and go somewhere and use a flat brush for the crease. Like, she owned it. That's crazy. I feel like I should have blended this out when I put it on. It's harder to blend now. Y'all, I'm having such a hard time getting my eyeshadow even with a flat brush in the crease. Ah! What are you trying to do to me, Nikki? Okay, here's the picture.
Like that.
Like that.
Then we're going to grab just a little, just a little bit more Ogle pigment with my Sonia Kashuk large blending brush. That. Just go a little bit on, flick away any excess, and just go above that brown to blend it out.
Wow, she is using a...
Grab some more nylon with your 239, reapply that to the lid.
Whoa, how'd you do that so fast?
Just like that. And then with that Sonia Kashuk brush, go back in that brown from the Sponge Chocolate Club and reapply.
Well, so we redid all the steps quite a few times. So she did use a round brush for blending that out. Impressive. I don't even think I owned one 9 years ago.
Then, grab your Coastal Scents 88 palette and we're going to highlight with that one. And grab...
We're gonna highlight
the third one down. It's the one with the yellow tint to it. And apply that to.
We're gonna use Unbothered right here for the brow bone. And I'm gonna use. Looks like she's using kind of a fluffy brush.
The brow bone. Grab just a little bit more Ogle pigment to make it vibrant again.
We've put this gold pigment in the crease like 7 times now. Stay strong, eyelid.
And then again, just a little bit of that brown to darken it out a bit more. And that's it for the upper lid. Your lower lid is going to be really simple. Just
we're adding some of the darker brown. Oh, not supposed to do that yet. This Unbothered is like so pigmented. There is like no fallout from this palette either. It's like so awesome. Lower lash line.
We'll just take a little bit of that Sponge Chocolate color and apply it to the lower lip.
And tiny brush, tiny brush.
And go like halfway in. And that's it.
Halfway in, that's it.
I'm now going to line my upper.
Just halfway. Nikki's eyebrows in this video are as bad as mine were. Early 2000s, mid 2000s, those were not good times for eyebrows. 90s, not a good time for eyebrows either.
Upper lid using my favorite Gosh black ink eyeliner. And then I'm going to put on some mascara using Rimmel London's Glam Eyes mascara, and then I will be back to tell you what to do with the lips.
Okay, let's do it. We're gonna use the IT Cosmetics. Whoa, no, 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 we're not. We're gonna use the Urban Decay's Mood.
Okay, so be right back. Okay, so what we're now going to do is our lips.
She did the eyeliner off camera. No, okay.
As usual, I'm...
Okay, so it looks like she just put it in here. She did put a lot on there. And then it looks like it was on the top too. Oh gosh, doing eyeliner on the top with pencils. Haven't done that in a really long time. Looks like it's bigger towards the outer edge of the eye too. Okay, and she did her mascara off camera too. We're gonna do it on camera. Oh shoot. Okay. Assume the position. No!
I got mascara on my Nikki Tutorials creation.
I'm going to use my Gosh lipstick in Darling. So when you've got that on.
Oh my gosh, it's like the color of foundation. You're taking me back. Okay, I gotta find a lipstick that is as light as my foundation. I did it. Okay, NYX. This is NYX Cairo. She doesn't use any lip liner. Where'd my lips go? Look at me trying to overdraw with this. It ain't gonna happen.
On, you take some Sugar Rimmed Dazzle Glass by MAC and get that on your lips.
We gotta get lip gloss on our lips. Okay.
And that's it. Okay guys, I hope you like this everyday Christmas look. It's really nice for Christmas, especially with that green Christmas in it. But I hope you like this look. Again, if you don't have Gosh lipstick in Darling yet, go get it. It's awesome.
Is Gosh still around? Copenhagen. It's still around! I'm shocked. Dang. So they have everything. They don't even just have like makeup. They've got all sorts of different things. All sorts of stuff. Wow. So they are still around. They're still living the dream, making makeup. Okay, let's finish this off.
I hope you like this and thanks for watching, guys. Bye.
Okay, all right. No contour, no blush, no highlight, no fake lashes. This is crazy. So here we are. This is one of Nikki Tutorials' very first makeup tutorials on the internet, and it is much better than I could do my makeup 9 years ago. So there's really not much to hate on here other than those eyebrows, but I had the same eyebrows, so what are you gonna do? I feel like we've all had bad eyebrows at some point or another, and you see pictures, you're just like, oh my, oh no. Oh Lord, have mercy on my eyebrows. I think she did a great job. Like, she's so good at makeup. I thought this was gonna be a lot more cringy than it was, just because anyone's first tutorials on YouTube are usually pretty crazy, but that was not bad. It's not necessarily easier to use a flat brush in your crease by any means. So the fact that she pulled that out and still has a super blended look, impressive. Let me know if you guys wanna see me recreate anyone else's first YouTube tutorial or first, second, third. And I will go ahead and do it again and kind of make a series. I think it was really fun. So let me know in the comments below down here who you wanna see get roasted slash recreate their makeup tutorial. Like, hey, thanks for watching guys. I'll see you in the next video, bye. I can't get over how small my lips look with no lip liner. I don't love it.